You count them.
Mr. George,
you can count them. The countless people. But 1968 changed everything.
More than 50 years, T, also known as Tad Snacks.
They first killed King, then Bobby Kennedy, as he exited a freedom rally held in a hotel, downtown hotel in Los Angeles, and Aretha Franklin was screaming, R-S-P-E-C. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. I did spell it right, don't know. Too many people get that wrong. I corrected myself, R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Take care, TCB. Hey, hey, hey. Well, the Beatles had conquered America. All of those acid-filled lyrics we sang as we did all kinds of things, like masculine and whatever else was available. Glue, I don't know. Okay. I was dancing in the Alvin Ailey company. We were all there working hard. We were on a furlough in London, actually, a whirlwind with Alvin. We had previously gone to Israel the year before that, and we arrived in Tel Aviv 6 days after the Six-Day War, and we stayed at the Hotel Dan next to the Jordan River. We shopped in the markets. We got even those headdress. You know, we didn't know what headdress we were buying, but we weren't buying the right one. And we put on our headdresses that were Arabic and not us, and put on our sunglasses and our Speedos. In downtown Tel Aviv, baby. Okay, when? I'll stop. And then all of a sudden we saw people slowly gathering. Well, we got back to the hotel, they told us we were wearing the wrong thing. Or when we were on our way to Tanzania, Alvin took us, we went everywhere. We were really very privileged. We got paid for dancing.